The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 7, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on February 22nd, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation. O conqueror of wealth, Arjuna, there is no truth superior to me. Everything rests upon me as pearls are strung on a thread.
Matta paratarang nyanya kinchidasti dhananjaya mahi sarvamidam thurotam sutremani ganaiva. So, the material and spiritual world, everything is manifestation of two energies that is explained by Krishna. Bhumi rapo nalo vayu khangvano buddhirevacha. Aparayam itastu vidhi me prakritim para. And these verses we have discussed today that etat junini sarvani. Whatever is manifested, material or spiritual, both of them are coming from the energy of the Supreme. That are heat and light. These are two energies of the fire. So, that is also explained in the Vishnu Purana. Parasya brahmana shakti sarvedam akhilam jagat. Ekusthani sitashtagne jyosna vistarina jatha. Parasya brahmana shakti sarvedam akhilam jagat. Sarvedam afilam jagat or sarvedam khalu brahma, the Vedic injunction. The energy and the energetic cannot be separated. If there is no energy, there is no meaning of the energetic. And there is no meaning of energetic if he has no energy. So those things are simultaneously present. The example, as we have given several times, is the sun and the sunshine, and the heat of the sun, they are always present. Wherever there is sun, there is light and there is heat. So, heat and light is the understanding of the presence of sun. Sometimes sun is covered, but still we experience heat and light. Therefore, we understand the sun is there. Similarly, Krishna, our God, is there. You have to understand by the energies, the material energy and the spiritual energy. That is already explained in two verses. So now Krishna is summarizing in this verse, because the whole manifestation, sarvedam akhilam jagat, the whole universe is presentation of the energy of the Lord. Therefore, there is nothing but Lord. Matta parataram nanya. Material world, we have got experience. The sun is the cause of all material manifestation. When the sunlight or sun heat, especially in Western countries, in this season, the sunlight and heat is practically not present. There will be snowfall, there is no foliage in the trees, every tree is deserted due to the sun. And as soon as from the month of April, the sunshine will be little more, increase, at once the leaves will come out. In the Western world, this experience anywhere, the sun is the cause of everything, all this material world. So you can say that in this material world, there is nothing, superior energy than the sun. Similarly, this is also a creation of God, the sunshine. It is stated in the Brahma Samhita. Yat chakshuresha savita sakala grahana. Savita means sun. Yat chakshuresha savita sakala grahana. Raja samasta suramutti asesha teja. Jashagraya bhravati sang bhritakala chakro govindamadi hurisam tamangaja. Even the sun, which is the supreme cause of this material world, even this universe, all the planets, they are rotating on account of heat of the sun. If the sun moves little this side or that side, everything will be blazing fire or frozen into ice. This is scientific truth. So, as the sun is the supreme cause of this material world, similarly, the supreme cause of, there are many millions of universes and millions of suns. They are all caused by the supreme energy of Krishna, bhumi rapa analo vayu, and aparayam itastu vidhimei prakritim para. Two prakritis, para prakriti and apara prakriti. So the Vedanta Sutra, that janmadasya jataha, the original source of everything, Brahma, that is Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, matta parataram nanna. Brahma is not supreme. Then Krishna would have said, Brahma is the supreme. But he says, matta parataram nanna. Brahma is the bodily effulgence of Krishna. Jasya prabha prabhavatu jagadanna koti. Brahma is not the supreme cause. Brahmana ahang pratishtha. Brahma is existing on Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, Krishna has the right to say, matta parataram nanna. There is no more superior cause. And the Brahma Sangita, Lord Brahma also says, sarvakarana karana. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadiradi Govinda Sarvakarana Karana. So it is not that Krishna is saying only. It is accepted by the supreme Vedic authority, Lord Brahma. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadiradi Govinda Sarvakarana Karana. The Vedanta Sutra also says, Janmadasya jataha annayat. Bhagavata explains, Janmadasya jataha annayat itaratascha arthisu avidya sarat. He is avidya. He knows everything. Janmadasya jataha. That is Krishna. And Arjuna accepted. Arjuna said in the 10th chapter, sarvamayitamritam manne jadvadasi kes. My dear Krishna, whatever you are saying, I accept in total. This is understanding of Bhagavad Gita. Try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is. Krishna says, matta parataram nanya. There is no more superior being or superior authority than me. If you accept that there is no more superior authority, a supreme being than Krishna, then you study Bhagavad Gita. And if you cut the head and the tail and accept something and reject something, that is not Bhagavad Gita. Take it as it is. Therefore we are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is. Not curtailing this or that. This meaning is that, that meaning is that. No such nonsense. We accept. This is Krishna consciousness movement. Krishna says that he is the supreme authority. We are preaching Krishna as the supreme one. Where is the difficulty? We don't manufacture anything. We don't say, I am the supreme spirit. No. I am rascal. I am fool. I am imperfect. But Krishna is supreme. Krishna is perfect. That is our preaching. A servant of Krishna. Therefore, Because we are presenting Krishna as He is, therefore our teaching is perfect. I may be imperfect, but our teaching is not imperfect. It is very simple. We are preaching all over the world. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of the world. And these foreign boys and girls who are after me, they also accept. They do not say that here is another God, sir. Why you are asking? That is the difficulty in India. As soon as we shall say, Krishna is the Supreme Lord, Krishna is the... there is no more superior person than Krishna. Others will say, no, why? This gentleman is not superior than Krishna. That is the difficulty. They will not accept. Their brain has been full with hodgepodge thing. Therefore, they cannot take Krishna consciousness so. Of course, at heart in India, everyone feels for Krishna, but they have been educated in such a wrong way, they cannot accept Krishna as the Supreme, as Krishna says, Mastha Paratananga Nanda. This is the difficulty. But unless you accept, unless you come to this point that Krishna is the Supreme, your education, your knowledge and everything is imperfect. Therefore Krishna says, Bahunam Janmanam Anti Gyanvanamang Prabhadva Vasudeva Sarvamiti Samahatma Sudullava. If you don't accept in this life, but if you are sincere to understand what is God, then we'll have to wait for many other lives. Life after life you have to struggle. And then, by the grace of Krishna, if you come in touch with the devotee of Krishna, then you'll understand what is Krishna. That is the beginning. Teaching of Krishna. Manushyanam sahasreshu kaschid yatati siddha. Manushyanam sahasreshu. Out of many, many millions of persons, one is trying to make his life perfect. Everyone, mostly 99.9%, they're blind, andha jathandhi rupaniyamana. They are being led by blind men. They are blind and they are led by blind men. Nathe vidu sarthakatinghi Vishnu. They do not know that the ultimate goal of life to understand Vishnu or Krishna and go back to Him, that is the goal of life. Taktadi hang punarjanma naiti. That is being taught in the Bhagavad Gita. This is the goal of life. But they are misled. They are captivated by this material energy that will be explained in this chapter also. Tri gunamai bhavai mohita navijanati mame paramabhyam. They have been bewildered by the three modes of material nature. They are not trying to understand Krishna. They are not trying to follow the instruction of Krishna. Therefore, they are in difficulty. The whole trouble is due to this ignorance. Therefore, there is great necessity for broadcasting this Krishna consciousness movement. There is great necessity. So, this business was entrusted by Lord Chaitanya, started this movement. Actually, Krishna started this movement 5,000 years ago and taught this subject matter to Arjuna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. But, unfortunate as well, we could not take up the mission of Krishna. The mission of Krishna was Jada Jadahi Dharma Sadgrani Bhavati Bharata Tadatmanam Sujama. As soon as there is discrepancy in the matter of discharging religious principle, means religious principle means the law of God, dharmanta sakshat bhagavatvani. Religion means the laws of God. Religion does not mean I have manufactured some religion, he has manufactured some religion, he has manufactured some religion, and another man is, yes, all religions are right, yatamat tatapat, no. That is nonsense. Religion is one. Sarva dharmān paritajya māme taṁ saranam. This is religion. Kick out all sorts of religious principles. Simply surrender to God, Hare Krishna. Savai pumsaṁ paro dharma, jato bhakti radhaka. This is confirmed. That is first-class religion which teaches how to surrender to God and how to become a lover of God. That is really. Otherwise, they are simply cheating religion. That is explained in the Bhagavatam. Dharma prodhita koitava tra paramaninmasanaram satang vastubabostubeta. Dharma prodhita, cheating type of religion, is kicked out from this Srimad Bhagavatam. Prodhita. Pakistirupena ujjita. And Siddhartha Swami gives his comments. Atra mokhavancha api nirastam. Anyone, any type of religion, they say the Mayavadi philosophy, they are trying to have moksha, to merge into the existence of the Supreme. But Bhagavad says, no, that is also cheating. Dharma, artha, kam, moksha, chaturbarga. The world, first of all, they do not know what is religion. But they actually, life, perfection of life begins from religion, dharma, then artha, then following the religious principle, you acquire money, artha, artha is required, but not sinfully, but properly, dharma, artha, kama. Then you have got senses, you require to satisfy the senses. So artha required for sense gratification, but that artha must be based on religion. This is called dharma, artha and kama. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. One who has surrendered to Krishna, understanding that Krishna is the cause of all causes. Krishna is the source of material energy and spiritual energy, as it is explained here. And therefore, Krishna is the supreme. And Krishna confirms this fact, matta paratanandanya kinchijasti dhananya. This is required. This is required. We have to accept this. Krishna says this. And Arjuna, who heard Bhagavad Gita from Krishna, he says, parabrahma param dhama pavitram paramam bhava purusham adyam. Adyam. You are the original person. You are the original Purusham Adyam. Adyam, therefore Krishna says, Matta Paratanam Nanyat. This is all confirmed. The audience, Krishna, I mean to say, Arjuna, is accepting and Krishna is confirming. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita is perfect. Otherwise, where is the authority of Bhagavad Gita? If you do not accept the author or the speaker of the Bhagavad Gita, and if we do not accept the student of Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna, then where is the study of Bhagavad Gita? It is something nonsense. You have to accept it, the version of Bhagavad Gita as it is stated by Krishna, and you have to accept the version of Arjuna as it is admitted by Krishna, then you are perfect in Bhagavad Gita. Otherwise, you have simply wasted your time. Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayajita Janayati Asu Vaiyagam Jnanam Chidat Ahitakam Dharmasanasthita Pungsa Vishakshena Kathasujat Nutpadayat Ratingjadi Samaye Vahi Kevalam. This is the Bhāsana of Śrīmad Bhāgavatam. Sarmaye vahi kevalam. Simply levering. Simply uselessly levering. If you do not awaken your Krishna consciousness by studying the Vedas, by studying Bhagavad Gita, by studying Bhagavad, simply Bhagavad Gita. This is the essence of all Vedic literature. Although it is ABCD, beginning of spiritual life, spiritual understanding. Unfortunately, people do not understand even the ABCD of this Bhagavad Gita. And what to speak of becoming graduate and postgraduate. This is the difficulty. If we try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is, at least we understand what is Krishna. What is God? God is explaining himself. And you are searching after God, making search. There are so many institutions. In Oxford University, there is a big research department. And here God is canvassing, he is explaining. There was a great controversy. What is that, Professor? Professor Jenner. So I invited him, so he did not dare to come before us. So there was another professor, what is that, sir?
Sir
Alistair Hardy. He came, he admitted, he is making research. So these things are going on. Why research? Everything is there in the Bhagavad Gita. Everything is explained and commented by so many, many great stalwart, it's a commentator. Especially Sridhar Swami, Ramanujacharya, Vishwanath Chakravarti, Baladev Vidyabhushan, so many great scholars, they have commented upon Bhagavad Gita. So try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is. That is the real necessity of life. That we have explained several times, this human form of life. Narottamdas Thakur says, that Hari Hari Bhale Janama Goin. My dear Lord, Hari, I have simply spoiled my life. Bhale Janama, Hari Hari Bhale Janama Goin. I have wasted my time. Why? Manushya Janama Paiya Radha Krishna Nabhujiya. Janiya Suniya Besukhain. I got this nice human form of body, especially for worshipping Radha and Krishna, but have not done that. Therefore, willingly a drunk person. Janiya Suniya Vishokhain. Golokera Premadhana Harinama Sankirtan. The Sankirtan movement is not manufactured in this material world. It is released from Vaikuntha, the spiritual world. Golokero Premadhano. Otherwise, why you are chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna? It is not material sound. Any material sound, you chant thrice, you will be tired. But if go on chanting Hare Krishna mantra 24 hours, you will never retire. Therefore, it is not a sound of this material world. It is the sound of the spiritual world. Golokero Premadhano. Harinama sound. Rotina Janimila Kanata. I am not attracted to this. This is the lamentation of Narottamdas Thakur, Vaishnava. Vishaya Vishanale Divanesi Hiyajale. In this material existence, this eating, sleeping, mating and defending with this business, always my heart is burning. Vishaya Vishanale Divanesi Hiyajale. Toribare Nakoinupaya. I did not make any means to get out of this. Gorokero Premadhana. Therefore, indirectly he is giving hint that human life is meant for worshipping Radha Krishna and chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This is the subject matter of Krishna Consciousness Movement. To understand that Krishna is the Supreme. Matta Paratanam Nanya Hinchi Dasti Dhananjaya. Mahi, here, Arjuna is addressed as Dhananjaya. Dhananjaya means the richest man who has conquered over wealth. In other sense, only Dhananjaya, a person who has conquered over wealth, he can understand that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Dhananjaya, Arjuna's another name is Dhananjaya, because after battle of Kurukshetra, there was no money. So, by the order of Maharaj Yudhisthira, he brought from the Himalaya range a great quantity of gold so that he could expend them for performing Ashwamedha Yajna, Rajasya Yajna. So therefore from that person this title was given by Maharaj Yudhisthira to Arjuna, Dhananjaya. So, Mai sarvam idam prutam. The example is very nice. Mai sarvamidam prutam sutremani ganaiva. Just like pearls. The pearls, take it. Pearl is round. And the universes are also round. So, all these universes are staying. Massani sarvabhutani. Krishna said, Massani sarvabhutani. Naham teshu avasthita. Everything is resting on Krishna. In another place he says that I am sustaining all these planets. Of course we understand law of gravitation according to our theory. But actually, according to Vedic description, the Shankarshan is sustaining all these planets. So anyway, it is to be understood. Just like all the planets are floating in the air in weightlessness. How this weightlessness come? That is explained here. Mai, it is resting on me, Krishna says. Mai, sarvavidam prutam sutri muni vanayava. So he is the ultimate cause. He is the cause of all causes. Sarvakarana karanam, parama, ishara, the supreme controller. In this way you have to understand Krishna. Then our life will be successful. Because this human life is meant for understanding Krishna. Vedaishta sadvai ahameva vedyam. This is the real knowledge. Unless you come to this real knowledge, your life is unsuccessful. Therefore Krishna says, bahunam janmanamant. Those who will not accept me in one life, he has to wait for many, many lives, but to come to this conclusion, that vasudeva sarvamiti, sa mahatma. If you actually want to become Mahatma, then you have to come to this point, that Vasudeva Sarvamiti. That is Mahatma. Mahatma does not mean by simply changing this dress. Mahatma means who understands Krishna. He is Mahatma. Because his soul is increased in dimension to understand Krishna. Vasudeva Sarvamiti Sama Mahatma Anastaman Pratha Devi Prakriti Masita. As soon as you become Mahatma, then you are no longer under the control of this material nature. That is also confirmed. Mami Vaja Prabhadanti Mayamitantarandi. Devidji Sagunami Mama Maya Durate. Otherwise, you have to remain under the clutches of Maya and punished by him. Krishna bhulya jeeva bhog vanchakare. Pasete maya tare japotiya dhare. These are simple Bengali poetry by Vaishnava. That as soon as you desire to enjoy your senses, that enjoyment of senses will not give you happiness. That is our practical experience. Anybody, call anybody, he is engaged in sense gratification, ask him, are you happy? He'll never say. We are practically seeing. These Europeans and Americans, they have enough sense gratification. Sense gratification means money and ornament. So they have got enough of it. Why they are after me rejecting this? Because sense gratification will never give you satisfaction. That is false satisfaction. Real satisfaction is when you satisfy Krishna. That is satisfaction. Krishnendriya Tritti Vancha Dhare Prem Na. Atmendriya Tritti Vancha Tarnam Kam. When you want to satisfy your senses, then you are under the clutches of Kam, lust. But the same endeavor, when you want to satisfy the senses of Krishna, that is called Prem or Bhakti. So Krishna is personally teaching why he should satisfy Krishna. Because there is no more greater authority than Krishna. We are trying to serve here greater authority. Everyone of us. We are going to office, we are going to party meeting, we are going to be elected president. So what is that? That I assure that I shall satisfy your senses. You want this, I shall give you. Please elect me. Everyone is trying to satisfy the senses. Either of oneself, he's giving false promise. Actually, he wants to satisfy his own senses. As soon as he becomes minister, he will satisfy his own senses. But he's getting elected by promising to satisfy your senses. But the sense gratification is going on, but there is chaos because the point is missing. There is no activity for satisfying senses of Krishna. That is the defect of the modern civilization. Therefore, one should learn that you are satisfying the senses of others. Try to satisfy the senses of Krishna, because there is no more greater authority than Krishna. We are satisfying the sense of greater authority, that's all. Or my senses. Huh? Because my senses are also greater authority. Kaam, krodh, lobh, moha, matsarya. These are very strongly dictated me. Do this. I don't want to do this. My conscience is willing. But my calm by lust is forcing me. So this is my position. See, in this position I will never be satisfied. If you understand that Krishna is the supreme authority and my only duty is to satisfy Krishna, then your life will be successful. Thank you very much.